want this self-sufficiency, where you are not dependent on somebody else. You know, whatever current situation is, somebody makes us a job offer and we become happy. And this happiness is that, what you just said, dependency. Now your happiness is dependent upon that person who would or would not make you the job offer. Do you like being in such situation? The other person has the power to make you cry or laugh. He will control your moods. He will control your mind. You like this? Do you like this, really? I don't like this. Do you like this? Apurva doesn't like this. What to do? We'll have to look at the way we operate this. Look at what you call as yourself. Look at what you call as your achievement, as your accumulation. Look at what you call as your pride. These are the things that you swear by, that you live by, right? Isn't all of that coming from the outside? Alright, what is it that you are proud of? What is it that you call your achievement? How is it that you know yourself? In what ways do you know yourself? What do you call yourself? I am asking about your very self-image. Main kya hoon? Main kya hoon? Isn't that coming completely from the outside? Somebody comes, and I'm giving a very simplistic example. Take it in the right spirit. Somebody comes and tells you that you are brilliant. And it becomes your self-image that I am. He said you are brilliant. And how does it translate in your mind? I am brilliant. Now, don't you see that your idea that you are brilliant depends upon that person? You will forever be afraid of that person. Because if you must accept when someone says that you are brilliant, you will also have to accept it when he says that you are stupid. You become dependent upon him. You will remain in fear. Because you do not know yourself. All your self-image, all that you can call as your achievement, your pride, whatsoever, is coming from somebody else. You may be passionate about your religion, some of you. But you never founded that religion. You know hardly a thing about that religion. Someone else gave you that religion. Won't you always be fearful of crossing the boundaries of that religion? Because it is not yours, remember. Won't you be fearful? Now, can you go to a temple and do something that is absolutely forbidden there? Can you do that? You can't do that because, honestly speaking, it is not your religion and it is not your temple. Even in a temple right within your home, you can't do something that is forbidden because it is not your religion and it is not your temple. And you do not understand those books that you keep there. It's all dependent on somebody else. Are you getting? Yes? Are you getting it? Is there anything within us, is there any way we know of us that is purely our understanding of ourselves? No. All that we know of ourselves comes from somebody else, some other source, and that has become our very identity. Our very identity, belonging to a particular nation, belonging to a particular group, belonging to a particular stream in engineering, and later on belonging to a particular company, a particular organization, as a son of somebody, as a daughter of somebody, as a later on as a wife of somebody. And everything that you have in life is dependent on somebody else. I'm greatly proud to be the wife of Mr. And Mr. is obviously not your servant. A day may come when that wifehood will go away and then you will collapse. Then you will absolutely collapse because now there is nothing left. All that you had was dependent on that Mr. Some. He goes away, you collapse. I'm an engineer. The worth of engineering in the market reduces. Let's say there is another recession, a deeper recession, and you collapse. Because you have nothing in your life except that degree. And your identity, you have greatly linked to that degree. Something happens to that degree, and you fall apart. Are you getting it? Who am I? You know, I am one of the top 10 richest men in Ghaziabad. I belong to one of the top 10 richest families. That's your very identity. And something happens to that wealth. Or let's say new millionaires come up. And then what happens to you? Your mind collapses. Because you have no sense of yourself except as something which is dependent on others. Something is dependent on others. And that makes you greatly afraid. Greatly afraid. Self-sufficiency, Pulkit, means I do not bother much about what I have. Remember this? I do not bother much about what I have because I know who I am. There are two ways of looking at yourself. One, in terms of what you have. Second, in terms of what you are. What you have came from outside and can be taken away. But nobody can take away what you are. When you will know yourself in terms of what you are, not in terms of what you have, not in terms of what the external gave you, but in terms of what is your intrinsic nature. When you know yourself in that terms, you will be greatly self-sufficient. Greatly self-sufficient. There will be no fear. And no fear doesn't mean that you will fight with everybody. In fact, when you are fearless, you are capable of love. Only a fearless man can love. The ones who are always trembling in fear, they do not know love at all. They cannot love. Love is not for the stupid and the chicken-hearted. Love is only for the most intelligent and fearless man. Getting it? Okay. Yes?